In this module, we are going to study about derivative of inverse trigonometric function. So, the question is, what is the inverse of a function? It's very simple. In mathematics, an inverse function is a function that reverses another function. That is, if f is a function mapping x to y, then the inverse function of f maps y back to x. Example, we are having two sets. First set is having the element a, b and c, and second set is having the element 1, 2 and 3. In between these two sets we are having a function f. So we can observe that the first element A mapped to the element 3, B mapped on the element 1, and C mapped on the element 2. Now, when we apply inverse function in between these two sets, then the order of sets will be reverse. Now, 1, 2, 3 will become your first set, and A, B, C will become your second set. So, in between these two sets we are having the function f inverse. Also we can observe that element 1 mapped to the b, 2 mapped to c, and 3 mapped on a. Now we are going to see how to find the inverse of a function. To understand this concept we are going to take one example. Let f of x is equal to 3x minus 5. So to find its inverse, we have to follow some steps. Step number 1, replace f of x by y. Means, jahan par f of x hoga, usko aap y likhoge. So therefore, y is equal to 3x minus 5. Now, step number 2. Swap roles of x and y, meaning जहाँ पर y होगा उसको आप x लिखोगे और जहाँ पर x होगा उसको आप y लिखोगे. And that is why we got there x is equal to 3y minus 5. Step number 3, solve for y. So अब हम y की value निकालेंगे. To get the value of y, transfer minus 5 to the left hand side. We'll get x plus 5 is equal to 3y. Now divided by 3 on both this side, we'll get x plus 5 upon 3 is equal to y. Step number 4, replace y by f inverse x. Means is y ko aap f inverse x se replace karoge. Therefore, we got f inverse x is equal to x plus 5 upon 3, which is the inverse of the function f of x. Now we are going to see the meaning of inverse function in trigonometric terms. Example number 1, sine theta is equal to x. So with the help of definition of inverse function, आप साइन को ट्रांसफ़र कर दो राइट हैंड साइड. सो विल गेट साइन इनवर्स ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू थीटा. सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल, कॉस थीटा इज इक्वल टू एक्स. सो अगेन विद द हेल्प ऑफ डेफिनेशन, कॉस को ट्रांसफ़र कर दो राइट साइड. सो विल गेट कॉस इनवर्स ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू थीटा. थर्ड एग्जाम्पल इज टैन थीटा इज इक्वल टू एक्स. अगेन टैन को ट्रांसफ़र कर दो राइट साइड, will get tan inverse of x is equal to theta. Fourth example is cot theta is equal to x. Again, cot ko transfer kar do right hand side, we will get cot inverse of x is equal to theta. Fifth example is sec theta is equal to x. Again, sec ko transfer kar do right side, we will get sec inverse of x is equal to theta. And sixth example is cosec theta is equal to x. cosec को आप ट्रांसफर कर दो राइट साइड, विल गेट cosec इनवर्स ऑफ x इज इक्वल टू थीटा. सो इन दिस वे वी गॉट साइन इनवर्स ऑफ x, cos इनवर्स ऑफ x, tan इनवर्स ऑफ x, cot इनवर्स ऑफ x, sec इनवर्स ऑफ x एंड cosec इनवर्स ऑफ x. दीज आर द सिक्स इनवर्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस. Now we will see some important properties of inverse trigonometric function. Sine of sine inverse x is equal to x, or sine inverse of sine x is equal to x. Cos of cos inverse x is equal to x, or cos inverse of cos x is equal to x. Tan of tan inverse x is equal to x, or tan inverse of tan x is equal to x. Sec of sec inverse x is equal to x, or sec inverse of sec x is equal to x. Cosec of cosec inverse x is equal to x, or cosec inverse of cosec x is equal to x. Cot of cot inverse x is equal to x, or cot inverse of cot x is equal to x. Sine inverse of 1 upon x is equal to cosec inverse of x. Cos inverse of 1 upon x is equal to sec inverse of x. Tan inverse of 1 upon x is equal to cot inverse of x. Sin inverse of minus x is equal to minus of sin inverse x. Tan inverse of minus of x is equal to minus of tan inverse x. Cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. Cosec inverse of minus x is equal to minus of cosec inverse x. Sec inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus sec inverse of x. Cot inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cot inverse of x. Sin inverse of x plus cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Tan inverse of x plus cot inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Sec inverse of x plus cosec inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y upon 1 minus x into y. tan inverse of x minus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x minus y upon 1 plus x into y. Now we are going to see the derivative of inverse trigonometric function. Derivative of sine inverse x is equal to 1 upon root 1 minus x square. Derivative of cos inverse x is equal to minus 1 upon root 1 minus x square. Derivative of tan inverse x is equal to 1 upon 1 plus x square. Derivative of cot inverse x is equal to minus 1 upon 1 plus x square. Derivative of sec inverse x is equal to 1 upon mod of x into root of x square minus 1. Derivative of cosec inverse x is equal to minus 1 upon x root of x square minus 1. Now we are going to solve some problem based on this property and the formulae. Question number 1. Differentiate the following with respect to x. The question is sine inverse of in the bracket 2x root of 1 minus x square. Let's see the answer of this. Let y is equal to sine inverse of 2x root of 1 minus x square. इसमें हमने ऑब्जर्व किया कि 1 minus x square is present inside the square root. So, we are going to substitute the value of x is equal to sin theta or cos theta. So, we will get an identity formula inside the square root, that is 1 minus sin square theta or 1 minus cos square theta. Let's put the value of x is equal to sin theta. According to the definition of inverse function, sin ko hum transfer karenge left hand side. So we will get theta is equal to sin inverse of x. Now we are going to put the value of x, that is sin theta. Therefore, y is equal to sin inverse of 2 into sin theta root of 1 minus sin square theta. According to identity law of trigonometric function, the value of 1 minus sin square theta is equal to cos square theta. So, we'll put 1 minus sin square theta as cos square theta inside the square root. We'll take the root of that. So we'll get y is equal to sin inverse of 2 times sin theta into cos theta. According to half angled formula of trigonometric function, 2 sin theta into cos theta will become sin of 2 theta. Now it is in the form of property, that is sin inverse of sin x is equal to x. So we will get 2 theta. Now we are going to put the value of theta, that is sin inverse of x. So we will get y is equal to 2 into sin inverse of x. Now we are going to differentiate y with respect to x. So dy by dx is equal to 2 times derivative of sine inverse of x. Sine inverse of x is in a standard form, that is why its derivative is 1 upon root of 1 minus x square. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to 2 upon root of 1 minus x square. Question number 2. Differentiate the following with respect to x. Question is, y is equal to tan inverse of 4x upon 1 plus 5x square. Let's see the solution of this question. Given function is y is equal to tan inverse of 4x upon 1 plus 5x square. Remember it, whenever we have 1 plus in the denominator and tan inverse is present outside the bracket. तो आपको करना क्या है, दो नंबर ऐसा सर्च करना है जिसका सब्ट्रैक्शन उसके न्यूमरेटर में प्रेजेंट हो और उन्हें दोनों नंबर का मल्टीप्लिकेशन प्लस साइन के साइड में प्रेजेंट हो। सो दैट टू नंबर्स आर 5x एंड x. व्हेन वी सब्ट्रैक्ट इट 5x माइनस x we will get 4x, which is present in a numerator, and when we multiply it we will get 5x square, which is present after plus sign. We know that tan inverse of x minus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x minus y upon 1 plus x into y. So according to this formula we will get y is equal to tan inverse of 5x minus tan inverse of x. Now we are going to differentiate y with respect to x. So we'll get dy by dx is equal to derivative of tan inverse of 5x minus derivative of tan inverse of x. So the derivative of tan inverse of 5x will be 1 upon 1 plus 5x the whole square into derivative of 5x minus derivative of tan inverse x will be 1 upon 1 plus x square. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to 5 upon 1 plus 25x square minus 1 upon 1 plus x square. Question number 3 is, if y is equal to sine inverse of 3x plus 4 times root of 1 minus x square upon 5, then find dy by dx. See the solution of this question. Y is equal to sine inverse of, in a denominator you are having 5, so we are going to split up. So we'll get 3 upon 5x plus 4 upon 5 root of 1 minus x square. Since 1 minus x square is present, so we are going to put the value of x is equal to sine theta. According to the definition of inverse trigonometric function, we are going to transfer sine on the left hand side. So we will get theta is equal to sine inverse of x. One more thing we can observe in this. When we do sum of square of 3 upon 5 and 4 upon 5, the answer will come 1. It means that we can put 3 upon 5 as cos A, where A is a constant, and 4 upon 5 as sin of A. Now, if we do sin square A plus cos square A, answer will come 1. It means that it is following identity law of trigonometry function. Students, remember that 3 upon 5 आप cos a भी ले सकते हो, इसकी जगह पे sin a भी रख सकते हो. सिमिलरली 4 upon 5 की जगह पे आप sin a भी रख सकते हो, cos a भी रख सकते हो. इट डिपेंड अपॉन द क्वेश्चन. अगर क्वेश्चन में sin inverse है तो हम ब्रैकेट को sin theta बनाएंगे, और अगर क्वेश्चन में cos inverse है तो हम ब्रैकेट को cos theta बनाएंगे. Now we will put all these value in equation number 1. So we will get y is equal to sin inverse of cos A into sin theta plus sin A into root of 1 minus sin square theta. We know that 1 minus sin square theta is cos square theta. So root of cos square theta will be cos theta only. So we'll get y is equal to sin inverse of sin theta into cos A plus sin A into cos theta. If we observe this bracket, we will get a compound angle formula of sin A plus B. So we'll get y is equal to sin inverse of sin of theta plus A. We know that sin inverse of sin x is equal to x. So we will get y is equal to theta plus A. Now we will put the value of theta, that is sin inverse of x. Therefore y is equal to sin inverse of x plus A, where A is a known angle. Now we are going to differentiate y with respect to x. Therefore dy by dx is equal to derivative of sin inverse x plus derivative of A. Therefore dy by dx is equal to 1 upon root of 1 minus x square plus 0. Therefore dy by dx is equal to 1 upon root of 1 minus x square.